Hello, magandang gabi po sa inyo lahat and welcome to another edition of Sports Kona PH Interviews for this Tuesday evening. At of course, maraming maraming salamat po sa pagtangkilik niyo po sa Sports Kona PH because we now have 55,000 followers as of today. And of course, we'll be focusing of course sa ating Paris Olympics coverage. But right now, we'll concentrate muna tayo sa ibang sports. And of course, let's feature about ice hockey. Ating Firebirds Philippine team have already won the bronze medal in the Thailand Invitation Ice Hockey Championship in Bangkok, Thailand, and they're back home in the country. And to get some sentiments and of course the stories of their campaign, makakasama po natin on my right ang kanilang forward si Miss Jody Dino. Jody, magandang gabi and introduce mo muna yourself.
Hi, good evening po. I'm Jody Dino and I play right wing or left wing and I'm 22 years old and I play for Firebirds and I'm also part of the Philippine national team for the women's ice hockey.
Okay, so you're part also ng bronze medal finish, no? No, last time sa Thailand?
Yung silver medal po
Silver,
for
silver.
AOC, yeah, Kyrgyzstan.
Yes po, alright. Thank you, Jody. Now, from Canada, Jasmine, before we introduce yourself, you're currently in Canada, di ba?
Yeah, I'm from Canada, yeah.
Okay. So we have with us the team captain of our Firebirds, Miss Jasmine Alcido. Jasmine, good evening there and good morning sa inyong area. Tell us yourself about yourself and of course, can you meet our viewers?
I'm Jasmine Alcido. I'm 18 years old. Just moved here from Canada, so I play with the Firebirds. I play center for them. I play forward. And I'll be joining the Philippine national team for the next few months.
Okay, so you're going to play for the national team. Finally. That's a nice development there. But we will get to that later about this good development of entering the national team. Si Daniel Ramirez ang isa pa natin kasama na yun. Pakilala niyo naman sa inyo, sa ating mga viewers. At of course,
My name is Daniel Mitch Ramirez. I'm 15 years old and I'm playing right wing forward and I played from Firebirds. I'm also a Philippine women's national team, also for U15 and U18.
Okay, so all members of the team are currently either playing for Firebirds and of course, our national team for either the seniors, and the 18, and of course the other 15 tournament. But right now, I have to ask muna si Jasmine first. Jasmine, how are you doing right now after this tournament? Did you have some training? Did you have rest right now after this tournament?
I'm doing good now. I think I'm feeling more adjusted after the first 2 weeks of being here, moving here from Canada. So meeting everyone has been good. So adjusting better now, yeah.
What about si Jody? And of course, bagitin din natin yung iba pang mga members na rin ng team na pinabibilangan nyo. Kamusta na kayo dyan sa Pinas? Jody? Naka-mute ka.
Hi. Actually, we're doing well. In the first few games, we're actually just really adjusting with ourselves, building our own chemistry. And it's actually our first time playing with each other, especially with the youth joining us. It was actually a great opportunity for them to experience such game. Because if you were to compare it here in the Philippines, we were a bit hesitant. We would give each other respect. To the point that we don't give much challenge to ourselves. So this opportunity, especially for the rookies, was a great way for them to introduce how hockey really is internationally. And it is a great experience for us all. And also, I'd just like to add how Jasmine also is a great addition to the Philippine team, as we're all really excited to have her in our team. She's really great if you've watched it, and we're all really glad to learn from her, as we have actually in the tournament.
Okay, so let's head it straight muna for to Jasmine right now. Jasmine, can you share to us how did your journey begin in ice hockey, and what's your reaction about accepting this role to represent the country as part of our national training pool of ice hockey? Your background and of course your previous experiences in different international competitions.
So I started playing hockey when I was like 6 years old. In Canada, everyone plays hockey, so I think I just wanted to be like them and wanted to play with other kids. So that's how I started. And I grew up in Canada just playing there, and I never played anyone outside of Canada. So with this last tournament, it's a great opportunity to see, you know, the other countries and play people from different areas of the world. It really opened my eyes to how, you know, hockey's being played just outside of Canada, that it's still really competitive and still can be, you know, challenge me. I'm super excited to join the national team. It means a lot, not just for, you know, me, but for everyone, all my family who supported me. So, and everyone in Canada who helped me get better and helped me, you know, get to this point. So it means a lot for sure.
By the way, Canada has produced different top caliber players, and of course, producing talents in different hockey leagues there, the national hockey leagues in Canada. What are the adjustments for you to train or to play from Canada and now playing internationally as part of the national team? What are your adjustments and similarities of the style of play of in Canada and of course the international?
I think the style of play, like when we went to Thailand, it can really like reach that level, the same in Canada. But some of the adjustments is obviously like just meeting everyone, getting used to playing with you know, new people, but also the ice, I think, has been a big adustment. It's there's less ice to get, makes it more competitive to just get on the ice. And also the different conditions of the ice is a little bit different in Canada with the warmer weather, but it's definitely, those are the biggest adjustments so far.
Thank you, Jasmine, for your time. We'll get back to you later. I'll go back to Jody. Si Jody po, siya po yung pinaka-ate ng Firebirds na yun. Sabi mo nga kanina, 22 years old ka na, ha? At ikaw yung pinakamatanda sa grupo, no? At of course, may experience ka rin, eh.
In all honesty, there was also another one. One more, I would consider veteran. Her name is Georgie. She's also part of the national team, our defenseman.
Georgie, wait,
yeah. Opo.
She's one of the members of the silver medal winning team nga ng dyan sa AOC. At kayong dalawa ang na-assign o nag-task na pamunuan yung ating mga Firebirds sa team natin, lalo na yung mga bagong salta ng mga players. Ano ba ang pakiramdam mo na bilang mga ate kayo ni Georgie? At of course, experience niya sa paglaro sa competing internationally. Ano yung mga natutunan ninyo sa inyong pakikisama at kamaradi? Kasama yung mga players natin, yung mga young ones, yung mga future ng Philippine Ice Hockey.
As the ate of the one of the ates of the team, of course. One of the things I've learned is, of course, to be humble. I was really humbled by the players, and also even our own players. I felt like after competing internationally, we have to push for more. I feel like with more players coming from other countries, like Jasmine, there's gonna be more players like Larissa. And also Jessica, I feel like we're getting closer to having or attaining the gold medal possibly in AOC, and hopefully in SEA Games as well, as we're also aiming to join in 2025 and Asian Winter Games, probably. That would be tentative. And my personal, despite being the ate, to be honest, I'm still in the learning phase. More players are much more better than me, and it's a great opportunity for me as well to lead in my own aspect, not in skills, but rather in my own values as a player. So, yeah.
By the way, si Jody, kailan ka nag-umpisa mag-ice hockey?
Actually, I started as a figure skater first. So I started back in like 2012. And
okay.
Then...
So part ka ng national team at na sumali ka sa mga local competitions back then?
I used to join in both local and international competitions for figure skating. But fortunately, I wasn't able to make it to the national team for the figure skating. And eventually, hockey felt more like homey or like more family vibes. People are more welcoming. And I felt like I had more opportunity there, and I enjoyed myself. Playing not only for the national team, but also for my teammates as well. As I've ever since I played for the Philippines, I've also made friends and great people to like be with. And to be honest, it's incomparable to figure skating.
Yeah. Ayun. So first time mo figure skating pero lumipat na sa ice hockey na minahal mo ng
Opo.
Rusko, siyempre.
Opo. So, lumipat lang din po ako. Like, I think I started, I saw it 2022. And everything was just really rush. Until now, I'm still learning. Still far from being great. But I'm really grateful for the opportunities given to me, honestly.
Okay, si Daniel naman. Daniel, paano ka nag-umpisa sa ice hockey? Medyo bago nga ang pangalan ni Daniel Ramirez. You're now officially part din ng ating national team. Pero kailan ka nag-umpisa? Saan mo natutunan yung ice hockey? Paano ka na-discover?
I was supposed to start playing ice hockey when I was a kid. But di muna ako pinush masyado ng dad ko kasi maybe hindi ko daw mabalas yung studies ko. So, I pushed harder noong 2022. So, I'm still playing hanggang ngayon. And ice hockey, it made me inspired sa dad ko, which is he's a coach. And he's holding a club right now in the Philippines. So, and half of our family were like playing hockey. So, I gotta push hard myself to work harder and be proud of myself.
It's right in the blood, Iza nga. Kasi yung coach nyo, yung dad nyo is a coach and a founder ng isang club. Yeah. Anong club ito?
Blades Ice Hockey Club.
Ah, Blades. Dito sa Pilipinas na ka-base?
Apo, local.
Okay. So, nag-member din siya before ng national team, yung dad mo?
Siya po yung pinakaunang national team po talaga.
Before okay.
Yung ngayon.
So, yung pioneer ng ating
yes,
ice hockey team. Sika nga, sabihin natin, pinagmanaan talaga mula sa ama, napunta naman sa anak, kaya nga, at of course, nagpupusigi nga na makarating nga sa, of course, sa national team at natupad niya, ika nga. Pero, ano ba yung reaction ng dad mo nung nalaman na napili ka bilang national team? Parang sumunod na talaga sa yapak mo. Yapak niya.
Masaya po siya kasi na-achieve na rin po kami pass dito. Siyempre, magiging proud po talaga siya. So, ice hockey is like very competitive. So, we gotta push hard ourselves na i-improve talaga kami. So,
okay, thank you, Daniel. And let's go back to Jasmine. So, Jasmine, how many members of the team that went just to Thailand for the competition? And I heard also there's also two national teams competing in the boys under 15 and under 18 classes too. And how's the preparation for the tournament?
I don't know how many of the national team went to Thailand, but there's a few that I know of. And then for preparation, we just I just arrived in the Philippines 1 week before we left. So I was able to get on the ice, I think, 2 or 3 times before we went to Thailand. But previously, I was practicing back in Canada very often. So I felt pretty prepared going on because I already been on the ice a lot. But the beginning was just getting used to playing with everyone and getting to know everyone. But yeah.
By the way, follow up, Justin, since you stayed in the Philippines for about a week before the tournament, how was like the feeling to skate and to train in our own shore?
The first time I went on the ice in Mo, it was really eye-opening. I never been on ice. It's really soft compared to, you know, the ice in Canada because it's very hot here. So it was definitely an experience I was very new to me. But in Thailand, the ice was a bit better, but adjusting to, you know, playing in a mall and also just adjusting to the Philippines the first week was all just about adjusting before we left for Thailand.
Okay, same question kay Daniel. Ano naging preparations niyo kasama si Jasmine, si Jody, and the rest of the team?
I'm really shocked at Jasmine because it's like really good. Pero I'm really had fun sa tournament kasama sila kasi this is my first time playing with, you know, like experienced people. Kasi when I was like on my first tournament, we got mixed up on the boys kasi di kami makamake a team for youth girls. And then the second tournament that I joined, we got joined into a not Filipino team, the Malaysian team. So because we can't make a girls team. So this is my first girl team na sinalihan and half of them were like Filipino. So I'm really happy na kabo kami and joined the tournament.
Tama ba? Ito na ba yung unang international competition na sinalihan ninyo? Sinalihan mo? First international competition. Daniel?
No, yung pinaka-first international is like 2022. Yung na-mix up po ako sa boys kasi di talaga kami makagawa na.
Ayun, so 2022 pala, that was 2 years ago, yung first competition ni Daniel. Si Jody naman, ano yung naging preparations niyo para dito sa tournament? At sino yung mga nakalaban ninyo? Kasi merong ilang mga teams from Thailand, from Indonesia, and New Zealand ata, meron ata yung pinadala dun sa competition ni Jody.
For the invitational tournament, recently, we went against like 5 teams. Was it 5 teams? Yeah. Because we had like 5 games overall. So,
sa parang round robin niya yung format ng team. At kung sino man ang may mataas na standing, eh siya mananalo ng tournament.
Yes po. So round robin siya. And then we won our first game against Malaysia, and then the preceding 2 games we lost against Thailand. 2 teams from Thailand, U18 and U15. And then the next 2 games would be from Shanghai. They also have U15 and U18, and then we were able to have a draw against Shanghai of U15, and then in U15? Wait, I think it's U18. Draw, right?
Oh, at pinagsama nga yung U15 saka U18 na teams for this tournament, no?
Yes po.
Pero,
and then,
meron kayo iwalay na awarding na ginawa, yung recognize niyo yung U15 saka U18. But please continue, Johnny.
And ayun po, gratefully we were able to reach the battle for bronze, which is against Malaysia once again. And Buti na lang. We won with a score of 4-0. Yeah, 4-0. So 3 goals from Jasmine and 1 goal from another player from the national team, Miki.
Okay, so how do you assess na ito participation ng tournament? And of course, it would be a great help then to prepare for different national and international competitions lineup because this is a great tune-up ita nga itong competition. Tuloy natin si John.
Actually, this is a great opportunity for us to get more experience as we all know that Thailand is going to be part of SEA Games and we believe that they're the most they're the team that we should be looking out for really since we've already went against some of the Southeast Asian countries like Malaysia, Indonesia, and I think Singapore, and successfully we were able to win those in the previous years.
By the way,
Yeah.
Thailand is also hosting the Asian Indoor and Martial Arts Games. Kabilang ba kayo doon?
Sorry?
Yung IMAG?
Ano po yun, sir?
Asian
Sorry.
Indoor and Martial Arts Games. Kasama ba yung ice hockey?
I don't think so. Di naman po ata kami na-informed. I think yung upcoming tournaments that we were only looking out for would be Winter Games, Asian Winter Games, which could possibly be held in February. And then, of course, AOC, the annual AOC. I'm not sure which country would be hosting it. And SEA Games, which is in 2025.
Okay, thank you, Jody. Let's go to Jasmine again. Jasmine, what's your assessment on the performance na ng ating team that won the bronze medal dyan sa Thailand? What's your assessment observations with the plays and of course the techniques that you initiate? And you also have goals during the bronze medal match against Malaysia, no?
In the last game I had I think 3 goals in the last game, but as a team I think we really improved as the games went on, especially as we went on to play Shanghai. I think those were they were really good, but I think we played really good against them, and there's a lot of the girls that you know they're very young and you see a lot of potential in them, and you know that if they just keep playing and keep you know, working hard that they can reach that level and continue to play at that level that we see, you know, these other countries playing at and where we want to be and where we want to compete at. But just to also get to know them and as people aside from hockey has been good and also super important to improving just within the team, and that will help on the ice as well. So just being able to see like the potential that this group has and will carry on to the national team has been very exciting.
Speaking of the national team, what are the expectations from you being part of the national team, and did you have hopes to select you as part of the national team in those competitions mentioned by Ate Jody?
I'm trying not to have as much expectations. I'm super excited now to you know, meet the rest of the national team and play with them and against them in the league. You know, after this tournament, I definitely opened my eyes to how competitive some of the other countries are. So I'm excited to, you know, play with the national team and practice for them so that hopefully we can go out and beat them. So, yeah.
Okay, thank you, Jasmine. Balik tayo kay Daniel. Daniel, ano yung naging assessment niyo sa performance niya dyan sa Thailand?
My experience, it was kind of a bit hard, pero we still doing our best and push the hard work para manalo kami. And I think nasucceed naman yung pagkatanalo namin. And those hard work and sweat that we did was worth it. And those hard work is also have fun and really memorable journey.
Okay, tuloy tayo, Daniel. Paano nakatulong itong pagsali niya doon sa Thailand sa inyong matagal niyong pangarap na may represent na naman ang national team sa mga nabanggit na competitions ni Jody kanina. Jump up kasi yung mga tournaments na nakalain na para sa national team. At umaasa pa ba na makikinig ka ng ating mga coaches na makasama nga doon sa national team na yun?
Yeah, I think so. Pero based on the the experience ko, I think I still need to work hard para ma-achieve man na ma-line up sa national team.
Okay, I continue to Jody. Ano yung naging overall impact nitong pagsali nga ng ating Pirates and even yung dalawa nating national teams natin doon sa Thailand sa unti-unting napaglakas ng ating grassroots program when it comes sa ice hockey, lalo na medyo busy ngayon ang ating Philippine team. Meron din kayong Women's League na nakalinya na ilo-launch by August 3, no?
Yes po, this coming, I think Saturday, would be WPHL.
Okay, so Women's Philippine Hockey League. Ito yung counterpart version ng ating Philippine Hockey League ng ating mga kalalakihan, which is mostly members
yes,
ng ating national team. And ikaw lang yung member na kabilang nga dito sa team? Or may team din si Joji?
Sorry po?
Ikaw ba part ng isa sa mga teams sa WPHL and even si Joji? Magka-teammates ba kayo o hindi?
Actually, yung mga sumali po sa Thailand Invitational composes more, most coming from our team, which is Team Pandan. But there are two more teams, which is Ube and Turon.
Oo, may
and,
kinalaman niya sa mga matatamis.
Yeah, Filipino delicacies. That's where the inspiration came from.
Kakaiba nga yung mga pangalan niya ng ating team natin. So, how do you expect na dito sa inyong participation niya doon sa Team Pandan for the upcoming Women's Hockey League? And I'm sure yung mga ibang teams, Ube, Saturon, nag-aanda rin for the gold medal bid para dito sa Philippine Ice Hockey League na women.
In preparation for the upcoming local league, the WPHL, and considering that most of the Firebirds consist of Pandan, including Jasmine, and Ate Georgie even, also Miki. Actually, majority, even the rookies, are Pandan in the Firebirds. So this is actually a great way for us to, you know, grasp how we play with each other and build our own chemistry, and hopefully we would be able to apply it in WPHL. Yeah.
Before that, meron kayong drop, pero ikaw nilagay nga dun sa Pandan. You also co-captain, no?
No. Si Ate Georgie po yung co-captain. And our captain for my team, Pandan, is Ate Danielle, who is also the captain for the Philippine national team. And then the captain for Ube would be Ate Bianca, which is the assistant captain of the Philippine national team as well. And as well as Ate Rita, who's also the captain of Turon, who's also the assistant captain of the Philippine national team. And they're all amazing players, which is really nerve-wracking for us because it's going to be the first time that we would be going against each other as we were always used to playing with each other. Yeah.
Ayun. Si Jasmine, you will be also part of Team Pandan, no? How are you excited to play in the pro ranks?
Yeah, I'm excited to play. I'm excited to play in the league. I think Saturday will be the first time I'm meeting a lot of the national team players, but will also be the time I'm going to play against them. So I think it will be a lot of fun to meet them, but also to play against them and learn from them and just, you know, watch them by competing against them.
Okay, si Danielle, you're also part of Team Panda, no?
I'm Team Toronto.
Ah, Team Toronto pala. So, magkaiwala pala kayo ng team.
Yeah.
Ano ba yung mga ina-expect mo sa Team Turon naman? Ano ba yung mga inianda namang pakulo o suganda nga ng Team Turon para dito sa WPHL na magsisimula sa Sabado?
I think mag-strive kami, mag-strive, and we're gonna work hard para makuha rin namin yung gold medal.
Oo nga, lahat naman ng mga teams ang kanilang inaasam talaga ay makuha nga finally yung gold medal na this is actually the first inaugural tournament. So, maybe in the coming years, lalaki, lalago yung ating ice hockey community and of course, magiging busy nga ng ating national team nga sa international competitions. But last question before we end. Are you looking, what are the goals na ina-expect ninyo kayong tatlo sa inyong career, sa inyong of course, sa inyong mga ginagawa niyo for the national team, and of course, to help our grassroots program din ng Ice Hockey. Daniel?
My goal is mag-training lang, mag-training until na mag-succeed ako mapasok into a higher Philippine national team, like joining competitions like SEA Games, ganun. And maybe sa age ko, I will not stop na mag-hockey until na basta until na hindi pa rin ako napapagod. I just gotta keep this dream kasi ito na talaga yung dream sport ko talaga. So I gotta push it hanggang sa, you know, make my... Yeah,
oh, okay. See, Jasmine Lawan, what are the goals in the entire career now part of the national team, the national training pool? What are the goals that you want to succeed?
I just want to keep playing as long as I can, like competitively, and that's part of the reason why I came here. It's a new opportunity to continue to play competitively, but while I'm here, I definitely want to, you know, improve, but also push the standard of the compete level here and try to, you know, inspire, but also like learn as much as I can. But my goals is just to keep playing hockey as long as I can, and whether, you know, that be through the Philippine national team or wherever that takes me, I definitely want to, you know, be the best I can.
Okay, si Jody naman, nakadalawang taon ka na sa national team. Ano ba magiging goals niyo?
My personal goal would be, of course, to be, or maybe to serve as an inspiration to adults who are just about to start playing ice hockey, and maybe provide them the message that it's never too late, even though you've got cranky bones right there, here and there, but then... I would like to serve as an example. And also, probably the main goal as for the community would be to expand the hockey community, as you all know that hockey here in the Philippines is not really that prominent yet. It's not really well known considering that Philippines is a tropical country. So hopefully with the girls coming from different countries as well, have the chance to like serve as an inspiration to other players as well, especially the young ones. I believe that we are a young team, therefore we have more opportunity to come and better potential, especially now that we're more thriving.
All right, and congratulations to the rest of the Firebirds team for a job well done for the Thailand Invitation Ice Hockey. And we look forward to seeing you all each other again at baka pwede natin dumalaw kayo sa mga laro nga ng WPCHM even though late time. Usually 9 p.m. or 7 p.m. ata yung games, no, Jody?
Ngayon po, I think the usual time would be 8:45 po. And then we're gonna be trying 2 games a day.
Oh, so medyo late na pa sa akin. Pero please monitor us kung ano mga relax na sa WPHS and please update us on the sports and updates, and we will have some space na dito sa sports corner. So it's time for us to say goodbye, but before that, We want to thank all those who have been supporting the Firebirds para dito sa Thailand campaign. Daniel. Daniel, closing the mic for.
Ano po li yun?
Final words, closing the mic for. Salamat.
Thank you so much for interviewing us, as Firebirds, and we really, really appreciate for us to, you know, like, ipakilala niyo po kami sa lahat for winning the bronze.
Thank you so much, Daniel. Si Josie naman po tayo. Josie, your final words and of course,
First, I would like to thank our families for being as supportive as they are, for providing whatever we needed in the tournament, as well as PST, as they were also able to somehow sponsor our tournament as well. And our team manager, Miss Imelda, for organizing our team and be able to get into the invitational tournament. And I would also like, of course, to thank my teammates and even the teammates that I've met in teammates from Taipei who also played for us. We were really grateful for their dedication to join our team. Despite our first meet, they were able to we were able to learn from them. And lastly, would also like to thank you, Sir Gab, for giving us the opportunity to have more exposure in regards to our sport.
Okay, yeah. That's it. Your final words, very good. If you want to thank all those who have supported. I only have one minute.
I should thank like my family. It's been a hard decision to come here, but they made it easier, made it more smoother. But I thank all the girls who made the trip so fun and a great experience. All the managers and everyone involved who made it possible.
All right, thumbs up po tayo for the photo op. Thumbs up. 1, 2, 3. All right, thank you so much, Chris. Again, congratulations and see you around. Bye-bye po, maraming salamat. Thank you po.